First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intentions straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
Peace. Once again, we back. Dr. Alim El-Bey show. And tonight is going to be the discussion on alkaline electrical foods, enzymes, vitamins, and minerals. And we're going to go right into it. The first key to health, number one, is proper thoughts. I remember I knew a sister in Atlanta, Georgia, and she was a vegan. The next time I seen her, she had a heart attack, and she was just getting out the hospital. So even with the proper diet, if she never changed her mind state, the healing process or the prevention of a disease is hard to obtain or hard to maintain also. I should say, even if you're eating the proper foods. Once again, as we were saying with the water last week, it deals with the intent. It's also with the food, because the more alkaline the food is, means that the more water content is in the food. The more dense the food is, obviously, it's more acidic. So if you ever read the Kabbalion by the three initiates, it states that the all is mind and the universe is mental. All right? Now, you can get this book called Holographic Universe by Michael Talbert. And what he speaks on in there is something which that y'all definitely need to grasp. This is what he was saying. He speaks about the fact that Dr. David Brown said that matter is a kind of condensed or frozen light. Right? Now, there's another guy by the name of Dr. Prebram, in which that he believes that the brain itself is a hologram, but so is the universe. He believed that the memories are encoded not in neurons or small groupings of neurons, but in patterns of nerve impulses that crisscross the entire brain in the same way the patterns of light lasers interferes crisscrossing the entire area of a piece of film containing a holographic image. According to Dr. Frank Barr, a research physician at the California Institute for the Study of Consciousness, he states that light-sensitive molecules, melanin, found throughout the body may be a holographic film in the brain. Now, Barr says that melanin, which is the most primitive universal pigment in living systems, and which is evolved in a huge number of biochemical interactions, direct activities of other molecules, and in effect, eat light and convert it into other forms of energy in order to maintain and evolve matter. All right? Now, this is important because the primary source of light, as you know, is sun, the stellar energies, the solar energies, the cosmic energies, universal energies, known as prana, chi, ki, ra, Holy Spirit, kahuna mana, many different names. The secondary source comes from the food that we eat. So the highest snapshot of light that has been encapsulized that we can eat is actually fruit. And the most alkaline fruit is lemons, limes, watermelons, cantaloupes, honeydews. Large amounts of water within these various foods in which we're talking about. Once again, the more water within the food, the more alkaline it is. The less water within the food, the more acidic it is. All right? It goes further to say that it is, he claims, it kind of converts it into other forms of energy in order to maintain involved matter. Excuse me. He goes on and says, it kind of slowed down light molecule at the crossroad between biological matter and energy. In the brain, he believes melanin acts as a black hole, which makes the holographic patterns possible. All right? Now, that's very important, and we'll see in a second, because David Primbaum states that he wonders how is it possible that the human brain can store so many memories in so little space? Well, it has been estimated that the human brain has the capacity to memorize something on the order of 10 billion bits of information during the average human lifetime, or roughly the same amount of information contained in five sets of Encyclopedia Britannica. All right, now they found that similarly, it has been discovered that in addition to their other capabilities, the holograms possess an astonishing capacity for information storage simply by changing the angle at which the two lasers strike a piece of photographic film. It is possible to record many different images on the same surface. It has been demonstrated that one cube centimeter of film can hold as much as 10 billion bits of information. So this is the way that they are saying that the brain concurs to this hologram is the same as this holographic or photographic film. All right? Now, they go on to say, Dr. Brahm says this. The universal hologram is projected from a super hologram, the matrix that is actually giving birth to everything in our universe. At the very least, it contains every subatomic particle that has been or will be, every configuration of matter and energy that is possible, from a snowflake to a star, from electrical waves to gamma waves. It must be seen as a sort of cosmic storehouse of what that is. All right, so this is the super matrix. So when we get into that science, then this makes sense on the causes of all diseases, which has its roots in the brain via the mind. And it is there that primarily there lies the cure for all diseases. All right, the mind is expressed as a subatomic, atomic, molecular, cellular, tissue, muscle, and skin levels. Now, the same mind is in our central nervous system, our genes, antibodies, enzymes, hormones, and all expressions of intelligence. In other words, the mind exists not only in the brain, but all throughout the body itself. There's 76 trillion cells in the body. So every thought you have activates a messenger molecule in your brain, as well as also throughout the body. This means that every mental impulse gets transformed automatically into biological information. So negative seeds in the form of anger, fear, lust, greed, jealousy, envy, hatred, or attachments takes root in whatever organ is depleted of energy. Now, you go to Angel's Body, Timeless Mind by Dr. Deepak Chopra, we find out, this is what he says, that, for example, the liver stores anger, kidney stores fear, the lungs store disappointment, the pancreas stores sadness, the heart stores hatred, the brain stores stress, and the genital stores rejection, et cetera. Now, this goes real well with the biblical verse in Job 3:25, where it says, "For the thing which I feared the most has now come upon me." All right? So once again, this shows that by you thinking a negative thought, you actually magnify and draw that experience to you as a learning lesson. So hence they call that karma or cause and effect. But that means that the mind must be able to correct those conditions also. So instead of thinking a negative thought, you would think the opposite of the negative thought. All right? In other words, instead of thinking that something is going to come at you, think in terms of something great coming at you, not something negative coming at you. All right? These are all the sciences on how to control the science of the mind. All right? They found that 99% of all diseases manifest as a direct or indirect result of the negative programming of the lower mind. So diseases are caused by two problems, toxicity and or deficiency. But the first thing that must be corrected is the mind. All right? So this is where we have to get the greater understanding of this information. So we looked at a good example of that on the movie Matrix. Morpheus showed Neo a Duracell battery and told Neo that this is all we are to them, Neo. You know, and by him holding up that battery and showing it to Morpheus, showing that battery to Neo, what he was actually showing was that we are energy sources. All right? So true, we are a battery. Our body is a battery. All right. Now, you look on a box or a pack of batteries, it says that they're alkaline batteries. That means when you take the battery out the pack, you can actually touch it with your tongue and you feel like a spark. What that simply means is that there's life in that battery. As the battery begins to die because of the acidic level and because of it not being able to be recharged, no longer you will feel that spark. That's the same thing with the physical body. You know, I see you walking, talking, relating in everyday life, then there's a spark in you. When you're laying in the coffin, there is no spark. So the body has turned completely acidic. While you are living, there's alkalinity in which that is keeping you alive. In other words, when the battery is alive and the output in the electrical charges, it is alkaline, but when it is dead, it is acidic, all right? And our body is about 25% acidic and 75% alkaline. It is recommended that we consume roughly 25% acidic food and 75% alkaline food, as our body is also 75% water and 25% mass for earth. So when your body is too acidic, you will feel ill, sick, suffer from ailments and disease. So being that your body is 75% water, is very important of the type of water that you intake, as well as also the foods to which that you intake. All right, once again, alkaline foods or electrical foods. The highest alkaline foods are lemons, limes, watermelons, cantaloupes, grapefruits, mangoes, papayas, broccoli, garlic, onions, almonds, etc. All right, we need to be eating that, especially during the summertime. Many times a day, all right? It says, as a matter of fact, Let me ask you this question, Coach. I was asked this question. That lemons are acidic. Well, lemons are acid. However, in the stomach, it produces alkaline ash or residue. And basically what that means is that within your stomach it is alkaline. So actually you can actually squeeze a lemon or a lime, you know, in your water, and the alkalinity will increase to a healthier level, the water to a healthier level, all right? It's great in helping to detoxify the liver and the kidneys when you do that. And you can also add a pinch of cayenne pepper or red pepper in order to help with that process. Very important things that we have to do in order to maintain good health. Now, the battery also is symbolic to the melanin. All right, melanin can be viewed as a battery that is partially charged and can always accept an electrical charge. So the reason why you eat food is because it's supposed to produce an electrical charge. Why are you eating food that produces no electrical charge whatsoever? That's the question you need to ask yourself. Once again, 75 and above percent of the food that you eat should be alkaline. Roughly 25 and below percent should be acidic. That's about the proper ratio. All right, there was a Sweden doctor. I'm trying to think of his name. Can't think of his name right now, but he was a Swedish doctor. And I'll get his name in a second. And he basically broke down the ratio. Matter of fact, he said his name was Dr. Ragnar Berg. He was a world famous Swedish nutritionist. And he breaks down that 80% alkaline and 20% acidic is the recommended proper ratio of daily food intake. All right? And he said, this is the proper balance for the body. Now, what I'm saying is, correlates to, once again, how much water is on the earth, 3/4 water, and 95%, just like it is within your physical body. So all this correlates. Now, Dr. Mary Ruth Swoop, she comments that acidiosis destroys bones, and to maintain the blood pH levels, which is 7.35 to 7.45 from the acid range, which is below 7.0, the body has a tendency to steal alkalizing minerals from them. Your blood holds around 2/3 more oxygen. The human body has an optimum pH value at that 7.35 state, and what is called homeostasis. Now, this water-based medium can be either acidic or alkaline, as we know. So the proper foods, you can actually get online and go into more of the proper foods. We'll get to that in a second. I want to go over some more information. Herman Ayara, in his book entitled Acid and Alkaline, he states that the condition of our extracellular fluids, especially the blood, becomes acidic. Our physical condition will first manifest first tiredness, primeness, to catching colds, etc. When these fluids become more acidic, our condition then manifests as pains and suffers, such as headaches, migraines, chest pains, stomach aches, etc. Now, you get another book by Kiyachi Morishaki. In his book, it's called Hidden Truth of Cancer. If the blood develops a more acidic condition, then our bodies inevitably deposit these excess acidic substances in some area of the body, such that the blood will not be able to maintain an alkaline condition, which will cause these areas, such as the cells, to become acidic and lower in oxygen. When the cells are low in oxygen, pathogens, bacteria, viruses, microforms create acidifying toxins in the body, mucus. And as the body becomes more and more acidic, bad bacteria, yeast, viruses, and other microforms will proliferate in the body. Since these organisms are living, they eat as well as create resultant toxins. These toxins are often very acidic, acidifying. All right? Now, when we get into Mona Harris, she said something very important, Dr. Mona Harrison. She said something very important. She said that cancer tumors, et cetera, cannot live in alkaline water. All cancer patients should be on alkaline water, and you and I should be drinking alkaline water, so our bodies won't provide an environment for cancerous tumors to live. Cancer is a long period of mineral deficiency caused by an over-acid condition of the body, SIDS, or the beginning of tumors, which leads to cancer, because minerals are deficient from the part of the body. All right? Now, what they have discovered is that the salt content within the human body is very low in cancer patients. If you read Your Body Many Cries for Water by Dr. Batman, Jahalidi, he states, he states something very important. As a matter of fact, him and Dr. Mona Harris died under mysterious conditions around the same time in the same year, 2004, asking for their water information and the science of food. He says this is that when there isn't enough water in the body, or the body becomes dehydrated, 66% of the water lost is from the interior of the cells, 26% is from the environment around the cells, and only 8% is lost from the vascular system. But the vascular system is an elastic system. It tightens up, which causes hypertension. This is where high blood pressure comes from. So if a person drank water on a regular basis and took enough salt or minerals to expand the the vascular system, the hypertension actually would disappear completely. All right? So, and that goes for many of the conditions in which that he spoke about, asthma, bronchitis, diabetes, cancer, so forth and so on. All right? These are just some of the things in which that they have found. All right? So, it's not good to have a so-called salt-free diet. Right, salt would be taken out the bones to maintain vital blood levels. 27% of the salt content of the body is stored as crystals in the bones, which makes them hard. All right, so in the salt-free diet, water will not stay in circulation long enough to completely fill all the blood vessels. And that's another reason to high blood pressure or hypertension. Low salts and high acidic acidity in some cells, this is what it says, high acid levels can damage DNA and may initiate the cancer formation. Now, this is what I was saying, is that many cancer patients have low salt levels. So when the body retains salt, it does so to retain water. So an excess acid in the body, fluid develops when base or bicarbonate is lost. So the salt can be taken in the form of sea salt and make sure that it has the necessary nutrient or mineral called iodine in it. Iodine helps with the metabolism, helps with the thyroid. The reason why there's a lot of thyroid issues going on these days is because the people are not taking enough or getting enough iodine. All right? The salt that's on the tables at these restaurants do not have the necessary mineral in the salt. So that salt is dead salt. In order for the salt to be alive, it must have iodine. Iodine, once again, helps with the manufacture of thyroxine from the thyroid glands and parathyroid glands, in which it helps with the metabolism. It helps with breaking down infections. Your body won't get infections if you have the proper amount of iodine. When you begin to start getting the proper amount of iodine, infection disappears. Brothers who's impotent, that's what comes back. No erections. So it's not just a mental condition, which, as we said, most diseases start first mentally, and over time develop grooves within the brain in which that you keep having those same negative thoughts, and you actually are being detrimental to yourself because of these thoughts and which that you keep thinking. And whatever organ is depleted of energy, those particular thoughts, you know, which that you've been resonating at, which is low frequency, will cause disease to come in. Any occultists would tell you that when they look at the auric field, they can see leaks and holes within the person's auric field. Now, the normal auric field expands about 3 feet from outside the physical body. Well, we've been given a technique for several months now on this radio show in which that strengthens the auric field and expands the auric field from beyond 3 feet to 15 feet. And that is 6-3-6-3. You will breathe in for a count of six, hold it for three, breathe out for a count of six, and hold it for three. And you will do that breath technique 100 times daily. And at the, and on the 100th breath, the auric field will expand from 3 to 15 feet. So this means that it will strengthen your auric field and will actually diminish those thoughts in which that you've been resonating at and cause you to have to resonate at a higher frequency, at a higher vibration. And that's where you really want to be at, especially in this day and time, especially with these solar flares in which that's taking place. Transformers all over the country are being blown up because of the intensity of these solar flares, mega flares, super flares, and whichever bombarding the planet Earth, and it's going to converge and it's going to actually intensify by 11/11, November 11, 2011. This is what everybody's been talking about. This is according to the OMEC Mayan calendar. So we have to pay close attention to what's going on. We spoke about the fact that being that the sun is the primary source of energy, the sun is the light of the world. This is where the concept of Jesus being called the Son of God and he being called the light of the world comes from. If you don't believe me, then, of course, you know, if you have your opinions on which that can verify it, you can go and check out Jordan Maxwell. Kersey Graves, the World 16 Crucified Sapiens, Gerald Massey, Ancient Egypt, the Light of the World, the Book of Beginnings, the Gerald Massey Lectures. So these are things in which that you have to understand. All right? You have to understand this. So, some of the best alkaline vegetables are asparagus, barley, grass, beet, greens, beets themselves, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, red pepper, which is cayenne pepper also, in its hotter form. And then, of course, you have the bell, red peppers, green peppers, different colored peppers, carrots, cauliflower, even though there's many who say that carrots are a hybrid. Let's make that. Is it a natural hybrid or man-made hybrid? Supposedly carrots are a cross hybrid between yams as well as parsnips. The reason why the Moors made that particular combination because they knew of us coming up from out of slavery and that the disconnection and the disassociation which that we would experience based on the self-hatred that we would have learned because of their experience of slavery and being taught that we were slaves, that we would have damaged our navel chakra, which happened to be the color orange. So the carrots was produced in order to help with the reconnection to that particular chakra because in Qigong, that is where you store your life force energy at in order to expand your life and to live long, to have a disease-free, expansive life. Matter of fact, if you read in the Tao or Taoism, they speak about the eight immortals. So it is also where you can actually gain immortality from by the ability to absorb energy into your navel chakra. So this is the reason why the carrot was produced. No one has told you this. So people just tell you that it's a hybrid. Well, give me the explanation behind the science of it. I just don't want to hear surface dwelling information. I want to hear underground information. You know, my name is Osar. You know, that's my first name is Osar, Osaru. So I'm the lord of the underground, so I want to hear some of that underground shit. I want to hear some deeper-level information. Don't give me surface information and think that I'm not going to go and research and find out the reason why our ancestors did what they did. This is how we all have to be. So we have cauliflower, celery, greens, corella, collard greens, cucumbers, dandelion greens, dulce, edible flowers, eggplants, garlic, green beans, green peas, kale, kelp, lettuce, especially the romaine lettuce, better than the regular lettuce, mustard greens, onions, parsnips, parsley, peas, pumpkin seeds, vegetables such as sea moss, seaweed, bladder wrack, spinach, spirulina, sweet potatoes, tomatoes, wheatgrass, watercress. Those are alkaline vegetables. Now, of course, alkaline fruits, apples, apricots, avocados, bananas, berries, blackberries, blueberries, cantaloupes, cherries, coconuts, dates, figs, grapes, grapefruits, honeydew melons, as you said earlier, lemons, limes, of course, nectarines, oranges, peaches, pears, plums, pineapples, raspberries, rhubarb, strawberries, tangerines, and watermelon. Now, some of the nuts is almonds, coconuts, flaxseed, hazelnuts, macadamia nuts, pumpkin seeds, sesame seeds, sunflower seeds, and then, of course, some of the alkaline grains and beans is mullet, lentils, lima beans, navy beans, pinto beans, red beans, white beans, buckwheat, amaranth, and, you know, so those are the more alkaline foods that you can eat on a daily basis. All right. Now, of course, those foods should be 75 to 80% daily eating. Now, the acidic foods is 20 to 25%, and those are, you know, we would say certain fish. If you haven't reached that level of being a vegetarian or a vegan as of yet, which most of our people have not, but it would definitely be intended to cut down on the meats, all right? The first meat that must go is pork, of course. And how you know that there's no pork product within the packaging of food in which that you might purchase is that it will have a K on it, which means kosher, or either it's identified as being halal, or it will have a U or a UD, which means the Union of the Rabbis, in which that supposedly the Jewish rabbis, the Hebrew rabbis, prayed over the food in order to, before it was put onto the market, packaged and put into the market, stores or supermarkets. So you would definitely want to increase your foods based on those particular symbols, all right, for those who just get into this information. All right. So, of course, you want to cut out the pork, then, of course, the beef, then, of course, the turkey, the chicken, all the fowls, and then, lastly, the fish. All right. If you're still eating the fish, then, of course, I would suggest that you get the book, How to Eat Right for the Four Basic Blood Types by Peter Diamanto, in which that he breaks down the four blood types. O blood type is the oldest blood type, which means the original blood type, which dates back nearly over 300,000 years ago. Then you have A blood type, which is a Agarian blood type. For those who dwelt in the high areas, such as the hillsides and the mountainous areas, in which that is oftentimes O blood type is identified with Africans and African Americans, as they would say, people of color, for lack of a better term. A blood type is normally identified with the Europeans, West Europeans in particular, and some of the Asians. And B blood type is usually that of balanced blood, in which that is identified with Eastern Europeans as well as some Native Americans because of their mixture with the Europeans, the Spaniards, and so forth and so on as they came here to the Western shores or to the Western Hemisphere. And then, of course, you have AB blood type, which is the younger blood type, which only dates back 2,000 years ago. So we have O blood type, which is 300,000 years ago, A blood type, which is about 20,000 years ago, B blood type, which is about 13,000 years ago, and AB blood type, which dates back 2,000 years ago. So these are the various blood types. And if you don't know your blood type, we suggest that you go to CVS, Walgreens, or one of these other drugstores and pick up a kit, which is about $15, a blood kit, and actually you can prick your finger, and actually there's four areas which that you can take your blood and smear it onto, and based on the way in which that the blood coagulates on the paper will tell you the specific blood type in which that you have. All right, so These are the things that must be done. But some of the more acidic foods is barley, bran, oats, wheat, bread, white, or wholemeal, corn, starch, crackers, soda, flour, wheat, white, macaroni, noodles, oatmeal, oats, rice, rice cakes, rye, spaghetti, even wheat germ. Those are acidic foods. All right, some more acidic foods, like, for example, the dairy, butter, cheese, eggs, ice cream, ice milk, margarine, yogurt, then, of course, ketchup, coca, coffee, corn syrup, mustard, soft drinks, sugar, white or brown, vinegar, wine. All right, so these are more of the acidic foods. So, once again, the ratio is between 75% to 80% alkaline foods and 25 to 20% acidic foods that can be eaten on a daily basis in order to show forth that connection. All right, so, of course, it's not as technical or difficult as it sounds. When we talk about eating alkaline foods or starting an alkaline diet, we are referring to consuming those foods and drinks which has an alkaline effect on the body. All right, these effects are based upon the mineral content of the food and therefore the alkaline or the acid effects that it has on the pH of the body. So some of these foods have, as you know, the acidic effect, and it's usually those that contain sugar, trans fat, dairy, preservatives, chemicals, antibiotics, steroids, sweeteners, etc. Whereas others have an alkaline effect. Conveniently for us, it just so happened that the foods that contain alkaline minerals and these an alkaline effect are all the foods that we already know that are good for us. Low sugar foods, fresh alkaline vegetables, fruits, nuts, seeds, salads, sea vegetables, and water-rich foods. So it's not hard. So people always asking, I heard, you know, I know that when we started teaching on this information about 20 years ago, and we was talking about Dr. Sabi, you know, and when he went over his list of information, you know, there was always people come back to us, brothers and sisters, that would say, well, damn, what can I eat? So we always had to go back and say, well, you can eat all of this. As if there's nothing on which that was going Dr. Sage's list on which that they could eat. So, you know, so that was always a funny thing for us, you know, when we got to hear it.
Right. We have some questions we're going to go to. Someone asked, do I know what MMS stands for or what does it do? Is a form of sulfate solution, basically, in which that's supposed to help get rid of toxins and poison from out the blood. I don't know if there's any further question in which that you would want me to go in depth with about it and what it does. You can just look it up. Also, someone asked about the cell salt. Remember, we spoke about the 12 various cell salts, in which that is based on homeopathy. Products on which that in homeopathy, each of the 12 cells, blood, muscle, tissue salts, break down to a zodiac sign. Like, for example, Aries is potassium phosphate, Libra is sodium phosphate, Pisces is iron phosphate, you know. Leo is magnesium phosphate, and so forth and so on. So they break down to the 12 zodiac signs. And actually, we're supposed to have these 12 cell salts, muscle, blood,
tissue salts on a daily basis. One of the herbs in which that has all 12 of these, in which that is known, is dandelion. Dandelion has all 12 blood salts in it. And so that's very good in order to have on a daily basis, in order to eliminate and prevent disease. All right. We also had another question about the blood types between brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters are actually closer in siblings, are actually closer in connection as far as DNA and genes than they actually are to their mother and father. So it is possible that they will have the same blood type, but not necessarily. So it would still be something in which that you would want to, conduct, based on the fact that the mother and father had different blood types. If they had the same blood type, then of course, you and your brothers and sisters will also have the same blood type. So, like, for example, if there was two O blood types, mother and father was O blood type, then of course, more than likely, you will have O blood type also. Okay? And your brothers and sisters will have O blood type. But if they have different blood types, then that might not necessarily be the case. But you still have to get it checked out. The Obama speech, I don't know why we're talking about this right now. However, the Obama speech, when he spoke about the UCCs and African Americans, it's a Colombian, it's on Columbia, from Columbia, South Carolina. It was a speech right before he went into the presidency, November the 4th of 2008. So you would want to go back during the beginning of November, during the October, September time. It was one of the last speeches that he did in South Carolina, Columbus, in Columbia, South Carolina. He made that statement that all African Americans and serious-minded Americans should learn the UCC process. We have another question here. Mm-hmm. The Morgan diet. Yeah, the Morgan diet is the best, though. What that means is fresh fruits, a lot of different fresh fruits in the morning, along with some nuts, almonds in particular, is very nice. You can also do smoothies, and by lunchtime you can do the vegetable juices, so forth and so on. And then for dinner, you can do some more vegetable juices or fruit juices, depends on how you want to do it, during the lunch, probably be the best time to actually you can probably eat a meal. The reason why is because that between hours of 11 and 1 o'clock, the energies within the body is high enough for the digestion in order to absorb the meals. I know that scientists claim that supposedly breakfast is the best meal of the day. Actually, it is. All right. It actually would be lunch because during that time, noon, that's when your body is ready for digestion the best because the sun is shining the hardest. And the more powerful that, the sun is at that time, and the more you're in the sun at that time, the more that the food is being able to be broken down properly. So it's not breakfast, it's actually a lunchtime. They have all types of own crazy shit that when you actually analyze it doesn't make any sense whatsoever. All right. You got some more questions? Okay, D-type. All right, well, a lot of the Native Americans have B blood. It was also O blood type. And a lot of the Asians also have B blood type because of the mixing in with the Omecs, which is actually throughout the first dynasty of China, which is the Shang dynasty. So B blood type is balanced blood type. There's a miraculous quality about the B blood type. according to how he writes for the four basic blood types by Peter Diamanto. He states specifically that that B blood type have the ability in order to think themselves well. So this goes back to our first analysis in which that we were bringing down about the power of thought when we first got on. That is the qualities of B blood type. We should have some on the phone line. Arthritis means inflammation. Number one, arthritis comes from parasites in the body. So you first have to get rid of the parasites in the body. And how you do that is through black walnut, wormwood, and cloves. So black walnut, wormwood, and cloves, C-L-O-V-E-S. That mixture of those three will help eliminate the parasites, the worms, various bacteria and viruses, waste that is in the body, mucus that is in the body, will help neutralize the poisons and toxins. That is another well-known quality of black walnut, is being able to neutralize toxins and poisons. So that should be done first for at least a month or so during the cleansing out process. All right, and that should eliminate the inflammation itself once the waste is eliminated from out the body. The only reason why there's an inflammation is because redox signaling molecules are sent to that area in order to help deal with, along with the white blood cells, in order to help deal with the defense coming from the immune system, coming from what's called the defense system or the thymus gland area in the lymphatic system. So that's the only reason for the inflammation, is for those particular white blood cells and redox signaling molecules to take control of that area by fighting off the bacteria, the parasites, and viruses, the white blood cells, which have a large stay within that area. We get ready to take questions from the callers. So press 1, y'all, if you have any questions. We're getting ready to go and answer some questions online. Live online now. We're going to go to ending in 2820. Or excuse me, 2620. You're on the line. 910.
Okay. Peace, Dr. Alim. Can you hear me?
Peace.
Okay. This is for the Wednesday. Always a pleasure to join
you. Greetings, Brother Wednesday. How you doing?
Greetings.
All right. Yeah, I can hear you. Go ahead.
Okay, speaking about a seer, and I wanted to know, how do we go about purchasing that now that they have it at a shelf life of 1 year? Because I remember he was saying the product was only lasts 20 minutes outside the body. Now they added a protein to it, and so it has a shelf life of 1 year. But how do we purchase that product now?
Oh, you're talking about Sia?
Yes.
You can actually order it from us, and our number is 252-257-3588. That's 252.
1 second, brother.
25. Okay.
3588. Fantastic.
Yep.
Yeah, that was my question for the day. I had several questions about the blood type. Just to ask one other. O type blood, that's a universal blood type.
Universal donor blood, right. That blood can be given to any of the blood types during a transfusion, there will be no problem. However, none of those other blood types can be given to an O blood type.
Understood. Now, also, O type blood, is that, I am under the impression that that's the first, that's the original blood type because...
Right, that's the oldest blood type,
right. Because O type blood is... produces melanated produces melanin.
Right.
Or is, I don't know if I worded it right, but
mm-hmm.
I was reading that O-type blood is responsible for the production of melanin in melanated people.
Right.
Highly melanated people.
Right, exactly.
Well, thank you for allowing me to have this time. I just wanted to ask those questions, and I will be giving up with you.
All right. Please do, brother. Peace and love.
All right. Peace and love to you and yours.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We got you at 9239, ended in 9239, starting at 760. You're on the line.
Greetings, brother.
Greetings. How you doing?
I'm excellent. This is Sister D calling from California.
Greetings.
I have a question. I'm just now getting back to eating an alkaline diet after some time of putting myself back to sleep. I have two teenagers, though, 14 and 16. My son's an athlete, and he's complaining that he's not getting enough of the alkaline food. So my first question is, how can I get him to eat more of the good stuff that's good for him without him feeling deprived? And my other question is concerning chlorophyll. Is it still advisable for us to be buying chlorophyll and adding it to our distilled water? Or?
Well, the water that you would use isn't distilled water. It would be ionized alkaline energetic water, or water that is alkaline naturally, you know. So distilled water has a lack of minerals in it.
How do I get my hands on that kind of water? I'm moving out of California in the middle of this month, but right now the California water is awful. It's got fluoride in it, and even the spring water.
Right. Are there any, like, Whole Foods, any places, herbal stores, anything out there?
I live up in the high desert, and there is one health food store, but because it's the only health food store up here, it's a grip just to get any sort of good water. But is there a brand that I should be looking for?
The Kangen water is probably the better water.
Kangen as in K-A-G-E-N?
K-A-N-G-E-N, yes.
Okay, excellent.
Now, we distribute the water because it's the best water that we have done research on. So we can actually send you gallons of the water actually to California, I guess, until you make your move. Where are you moving to? Do you know?
We're looking between North Carolina and Georgia right now.
Gotcha. All right.
My husband's in South Carolina. We're just going to come out there, and we're probably going to end up settling in North Carolina. It's only an hour from South Carolina where my husband's from.
Right. Okay. So that's what we can do until that takes place. I don't know if you have our number, but it's 252-257-3588.
Yes, I have that number.
Okay. All right. And you know, if you need for us to ship you the water, we can ship it to you.
Excellent. Okay.
And you will definitely tell the difference because of the taste. It is all very different.
Okay. Right now I'm just putting crystals in my water and charging it with my own energy. You know, I spend, like, everything you say do,
right.
I do. I get out in the sun for an hour, and I'm on my way to the sauna now at the gym to sweat, and, you know, it's just amazing.
Right. Well, I know also you can use magnets, crystals. Like, for example, we have the alkaline water flask in which that there's 13 minerals in the water flask in which that when the water goes in, it can be even tap water. It actually will alkaline it and give it an ORP, which is the oxygen rate reduction, rate production, in which that it would take it to a negative, and that's really the alkaline water that you want is negative ions. You don't want positive ions. Positive ions
causes us to age quicker, such as within sodas and Gatorade and different other soft drinks, you know, as such.
So we just put regular magnets in the water, a positive and a negative, in the water?
You can actually put it not in the water. You can actually put it underneath the water.
Oh, okay.
You can also put symbols and shapes underneath the water, and the water, being that is has a spirit and it's alive, it actually would form to the pattern in which that you put underneath it. So, like, for example, if you put a six-pointed star configuration underneath the water will form, the molecules will form into a six-pointed star configuration.
Amazing. Okay. All right. All right.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Right. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. And real quick, information on how to...
Okay, another question. Green, say it again.
The teenager. I have a teenager son. My daughter's really, she's going with me, but my son, because he plays basketball and he's almost 6'5", but he's very thin. He is not really feeling the lots of vegetables in his diet at all.
What about fruits?
I buy two watermelons a week. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's the thing with the watermelons. I have an issue with that. They've taken all the watermelons. I can't even find a watermelon with real seeds in them. All of them here are seedless.
Okay. Yeah, well, yeah, see, we don't have that problem in North Carolina.
I only have it for a couple more weeks, but it's something, I mean, it's some science behind that. I was telling my kids, I'm like, really? There's not any seeds. I said, if you want to see the difference, look at the black seed, how big it is, and look at these little bitty limp. It's tragic.
Right. Well, I can explain to you what's going on. You have Monsanto in which that is trying to manipulate the market on seeds, and they're tapping into all of the seed industry, plant industry, and they're trying to monopolize that area so that we would have to come back to them. Matter of fact, they've created what is called Terminator Seed, in which that they have sliced off the genes, in which that will only give us one term of life for the plants. So that means that the plants will only grow for one season. It won't be like tomato plants, which will come back that following year, or spearmint and peppermint plants that come back the following year, or so forth and so on. They will only have one life term. So they want to control their market, and that's what Monsanto is doing, which is backed by the Rockefellers, you know. So that is what is going on with that industry, and that's the reason why you're having problems finding watermelon which has seeds in it, you know, because they want everything seedless, you know, because they want to control their market. Now, also, seedless watermelons means that sterilization, so it's also part of their population control agenda.
Wow, so I shouldn't even be feeding them these watermelons then?
No, not if they're seedless.
Okay. Well, you're giving me some beautiful knowledge. Thank you so much. It's a beautiful show. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. All right, you got caller 809, ending in 7565. You're on the line.
Peace. Peace, brother Tariq, how you doing?
Greetings, Zach, how you doing?
Good. I welcome to your show. I just got like a few questions. My first question is, I spoke to you before about changing, somebody can actually change their blood type to their diet. Do you know how long that would take? You know how long that would take to change someone's blood type?
It could take up to 2 years.
2 years?
Yeah.
All right. And that has to be consistent with the change, the foods that they eat. But with that book, what's the name of that book?
How to Eat Right for the Four Basic Blood Types by Dr. Peter Diamanto. Mm-hmm. I think it's spelled D-A-M-A-D-O, something like that. But his first name is Peter. But if you just type them into the engine search, how to eat right for the four basic blood types, this should pop up.
Four basic blood types.
He has a host of other books after that, too.
All right. I'm definitely looking into that when I get a chance. Also, my next question is about the water. How can you alkaline water, say water that was distilled, and you distilled it on your own, and you wanted to alkaline it? What methods are good to alkaline water? Right. Is it?
You're asking the difference between distilled water and alkaline water?
No, I'm asking you if I distilled water, I took water and I distilled it. How can
right.
I put alkaline in it?
Well, if you distill the water, number one, you have to take the water from a liquid state into a vapor state.
Mm-hmm.
But that's what distilled water is capturing the vapor.
Yeah, that's right.
But by doing so, the heavy metals or the minerals in which that was once in it is no longer there because that does not rise with the vapors over the steam. In which that becomes the distilled water later on. So what you have to do in order to make it alkaline is to add the minerals back into it and then alkaline it through the process of an ionizing machine or either through the alkaline water flask or the alkaline water pitcher or some type of other alkaline type of device or either through drops or either through sodium bicarbonate or either through lemons, limes.
Lemons and limes.
Right. So those are the processes for making water alkaline with some type of mineral content.
Wow.
The only time that you should be drinking distilled water is when you're fasting and you're trying to get rid of toxins and poison out the body. Other than that, you would want to be drinking alkaline water.
Whoa. That's good.
I didn't even know that. We're going to give it to you now. We appreciate you too this past weekend. This is Brother Talib. We got to give him a shout-out, him and Brother Olabala. Give a shout-out. Hit up the T-shirt place on the T-shirt that you gave me. I'm telling everybody.
Oh, yeah.
Just how to promote that.
All right. Yeah. Everybody who's listening, you can go to www.risingsuns.net. That's risingsuns.net. Rising, spelled, as it's spelled, suns, it's plural, but instead of a S, it's a Z, .net. The brother Malik, he's actually from the city of Philly. Via the way of Camden. I met this brother years ago on the streets of Camden selling his books. He was able to get himself a little corner, a little store inside of an indoor market, and he's selling his books. He's like the conscious book carrier in South Jersey. He got DVDs and all that, and he's just trying to branch out and do shirts. So if you want shirts like, that say the ass, you got melanin or you got a shirt dedicated to Black Wall Street. You got a shirt dedicated to all the ancestors. You got a shirt dedicated to all the Olmecs. You got a shirt dedicated on hip-hop, all that stuff. And he's actually coming out with more and more as we speak. So just hit that up if you want to order a T-shirt or order books. Yeah, definitely. And then, if you're in the South Jersey area, be it away Willenboro, New Jersey, South Jersey, just head on Route 130 at the Willenboro Grand Marketplace, and pretty much he's there and from Thursday to Sunday. So, yeah, that's cool. thanks for the spot.
All right, no doubt. This is Brother Talik. He took me this past weekend. We did a lecture up here in New York at the Harriet Tubman on 127th Street between 7th and 8th Ave this past weekend. We also did a lecture yesterday with Brother Azariah
at the Black and Gold Cultural Center, atop of the Manor Restaurant Juice Bar. And, you know, we're going to keep doing it. You know, we thank all of them, Brother Azariah, his mate, Mama Jade, Brother Talik, and his mate, Zola, as well as also Olabala and his mate, Elise. You know, so we want to make sure that we give out all the proper thanks for those which that are helping us put forth this message and get this information out to the people. We thank you, Brother Talib.
Yeah, I'm going to order some of that alkaline water from y'all, man.
Okay, no doubt. All right. Or sure, you can get the alkaline water pitcher or either the alkaline water flask, which is like the sports cup.
Yeah, I'm going to need that. Because I can't be drinking the distilled water like that.
Nah,
I'm drinking
right.
Some
say that it leaches minerals from the body. I won't go that far, but I will say that it's not the best water that you can have, definitely be taking in. Alkaline water is the best water based on just looking at, you know, the batteries itself. Battery is electrical. You know, our food is supposed to be electrical, but it's also alkaline also. And so, you know, that when a battery is alive, it's alkaline. When a battery is dead, it's acidic. So, I mean, just looking at that simple concept, when every time I break that information down to people, they can see what I'm talking about because everybody had batteries. And they all wish that they had the ability to recharge it. I know I did back when I was little. You know, we got that ability now, or capability now, to recharge a battery. But I remember when we had to wrap tinfoil around the battery and put it in the freezer. Okay? I don't know if you're on the what. People, wait. Somebody don't remember that? Somebody gave them amnesia? Oh, okay. I know. I'm about to say, I'm not the only one now. Okay. All right. So that's ghetto style, y'all. I don't know if y'all remember that. But ghetto recognize ghetto. Y'all know what I'm talking about, so stop tripping. All right. But anyway, thank you, Brother Talib. And we'll get back to some more of these questions here.
No doubt, please.
All right. Oh, okay. We're having some technical difficulties right now. So I don't know. Brother Talib, you still on here? Yeah, Brother Talib is on. All right. We're going to get back to some more information here. Somebody want me to know about PRP? Muscle tissue repair. I think that's the question. I think that was one of the last questions that we were able to get from out the chat room. Being that I haven't seen the question, we're just trying to remember it. But we know this, that so anytime these bones come free, iris sea moss, or what's called sea moss, is excellent. Kelp, dus, bladderwrack, the sea vegetables, these are very important. As a matter of fact, we are now in the process of writing a book on the metaphysics of water and the science of sea herbs. And it's going to be very powerful. And when you break down the science of sea moss, that is one of the most powerful ones that you can actually get into. All right? It's called The Blueprint, The Metaphysics of Water and Sea Herbs. All right? Now, iris moss or sea moss helps with soothing the skin conditions, any skin condition. In addition to its functional benefits, it has an excellent source of minerals. Protein, iodine, sulfur, bromine, beta-carotene, calcium, iron, magnesium, manganese, phosphorus, potassium, selenium, zinc, pectin, B vitamins, and vitamin C, host of vitamins is within sea moss. So it's an excellent source
of minerals as well as vitamins. Okay? All right. Now, it's a known fact that it's been able to even cure the symptoms of colds and flus. Okay? All right, so not just healing colds and flus, it helps alleviate mucus from the lungs, so hence any respiratory ailment, iris moths or sea moths can alleviate, such as sore throats, bronchitis, asthma, pneumonia, tuberculosis, can cure all of that, all right? Because of the high iodine, the thyroid gland exhibits, you know, requires this particular ion. So thus, iodine is required for proper gland function, as we said earlier. And so it also says that iodine plays an important role in the ability to fight disease, as we said, infections, cuts, germs that can gain access to the blood, nasal membrane, throat passage, intestinal tract, just everything. I mean, it kills so many weak germs. It increases the blood circulation through the body. I mean, it is phenomenal. You know, so Irish moss or sea moss is definitely excellent. All right. It also helps and aids in release of tension, especially nervous tension, which enhances the overall sense of well-being. All right. So it's one of the leading sea vegetables used in the relief of cures of diseases. Right. And the alkalinity of this herb, you know, is phenomenal. All right. It has sodium bicarbonate in it naturally. Okay. So we spoke about different herbs, and we said it's highly alkaline. We spoke about some of this before, you know. So another thing, too, is that when we get into particular herbs, you know, which, you know, I don't like just talking about which ones in particular, which is just, you know, necessary or excellent. I don't like talking about it in this regard because, you know, I hate to make things sound like we pushing products or pushing pills or herbs on people like this, some type of medical association. But I just know from my own experience and from me being able to heal others who have had cancer. You know, we have had sisters who have had breast cancer, liver cancer, and my wife and I have actually healed these individuals by giving them chaparral, yellow dock, golden seal, and different other herbs within a matter of months. All right? As a matter of fact, my wife's mother went to the doctor, and they told her to come back because they thought that she had colon cancer. So we gave her Allerferrox. Within 2 weeks, she went back. We're gone. They say this is not the same colon in which that we examined 2 weeks before. So we know that these herbs work. We know that alkaline water works. We're not talking from an imaginary belief system. We're talking about from knowledge, experience, wisdom, application. Okay? So we're going to go back to the line now. We're going to 803, beginning in 803, ending in 8110. You're on the air.
Yeah, peace, man.
Peace.
Yeah, this is Talib calling in from the MC territory, Miss Noma, Columbia, South Carolina.
All right, but how
are
you doing?
I'm doing all right, bro. I just had a question about herbs that numb, like Do you know some herbs that like some herbs that numb, some herbs that numb the body?
Valerian root.
Who?
Valerian root. V-A-L-E-R-I-A-N. Valerian root. R-O-O-T.
Valerian root. All right.
Yes.
And
in high amounts, valerian root can actually, that's where volume comes from.
That's where what?
Volume. That's where volume comes from. It's from the valerian root. Also, willow bark. Right. That's where aspirin comes from. Willow bark. W-I-L-L-O-W. Willow bark. So those two particular ones have to be seen in order to, in high dosages, in order to numb the body. Yes. As well as also get rid of pain.
Also, I wanted to let y'all in the family know about organic farm down here. It's called Asia's Organic Farm. That's ASYA's Organic Farm. They're organic dry farm, and it's owned by Aboriginals. Last name of the family is Mustafa family, and it's organic dry farm. By organic dry farm, meaning they don't use no irrigation. All organic. They don't use no irrigation. So. They certified, and I definitely support them. I know they certified. I mean, when the family, you know what I'm saying, when they support them, y'all gonna see that they certified once y'all taste the food compared to a Whole Food store or any other food that's coming out the store. You gonna see the difference with their food, and they locate.
Do you have the phone number to them? We would like to
Yeah, I'm about to get that to y'all. The phone number reach them at is 803-565-3674.
All right.
That's 803.
Give them the name again.
That's
803. Dry Farm. Dry Farm. Up on the Mustafa. Mm-hmm.
Right. Mustafa family. And you said the name one more time?
Right. Tell everybody the name one more
Asia's
time.
Asia's Organic. Asia's Organic Farm. That's ASYA's Organic Farm.
And the phone number one more time?
803-565-3674.
All right. Thank you, brother.
Yeah, they actually ship out the herbs and stuff like that. So, definitely y'all can holler at them. And they located in Misnomer, Sumter, South Carolina. But, they have a lot of events where you can come. I done been to their farm, check them out, how they do things. And, they certified for sure, man. Once the fam start, getting the food from organic farms, and then you can go get that, because they sell seeds and all that. So, I mean, you won't have to worry about too much, dealing with a Whole Food store to get everything, You actually can minimize that, because I don't get no vegetables from a Whole Food store no more after dealing with them. So,
Right. Well,
so, yeah, just check them out.
No doubt, because nobody else should be getting the food from the Whole Food store either, except getting it from them also, or either getting it from us. Which that our website is www.cultural-freedom.com. So that's www.cultural-freedom.com. And y'all can reach us through that also. And we also do organic farming. And so, this is the way that we need to hook up and connect, and this is where y'all should be getting your foods from. Besides being on the Whole Foods, which that we know now is owned by Monsanto. Whole Foods, or what is called 360 Foods, or whatever you want to refer to it as, is now owned by Monsanto. They have a heavy investment in Whole Foods now, so that means that you're no longer probably getting organic foods within there anyway, or what appears to be organic. There probably isn't organic food in there any longer. So,
it ain't.
You heard the brother, you got the brother's information, you got our information. Come on and help us out. All right,
that's powerful too, man. I'm gonna definitely check y'all out too. I ain't know about that. But I appreciate, you know, everything y'all doing, man. And I'll be hollering at y'all.
All right, thank you.
All right, peace, man.
All right, next caller. 313 Detroit, you're on the line. 313 Detroit, you're on the line.
Rogers, peace, family.
Peace, peace.
Peace. I just had two quick questions. I just want to give a thanks to you and your goddess. You know, y'all doing an excellent job.
Oh, appreciate that, brother.
And,
thank you.
I wanted to know, how long is the shelf life for alkaline conjuring water? I heard of it is over 72 hours to go back to its natural state. And dealing with, how could you tell the difference between organic and GMO foods? Because in Detroit, like, we don't have a wholesale food store or none of that. You know, I'm wondering, and that's a good thing. I'm glad you said y'all do your own farm. You say y'all ship too?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Could you ask
now,
the question about the alkaline water and shelf life?
Yeah, well, as far as I know and far from my own experiences, the shelf life for the alkaline water is 2 years. So the 72 hours, it depends on which one you receive. You know, if you got the 7.0, because the machine makes 5 different types of water. I mean, it makes stronger.
Okay, see, I've been on it since like, excuse me, brother. I've been on it since like about 2009 now, since the brother
right.
taught me about, you know, he guided me towards my consciousness. And I've been like on a, like, I started off on 9 and above,
right.
And now I'm on level 11.
Mm-hmm.
So is it, yeah, then I heard, like, I mean, it's working excellent for me, but, you know, that's myth out here saying that you can over-alkaline your body and stuff like that.
No, because your stomach is acidic, so you can't alkaline, you can't over-alkaline anything, you know, because your body has to remain at a homeostasis of 7.35, and we said that's what we talked about earlier, that's the blood, and that is the average alkalinity, you know, of the body. Only thing it would do is excrete out what it doesn't need, just like, I mean, that's the whole point of urination.
Okay.
You
and,
know,
like,
so,
up here in these northern states, I'm sorry.
No, I'm just saying that's the whole point of urination, you know, to excrete out what you don't need. Mm-hmm.
And, what can we do up here in these northern states, you know, when it get cold and, you know, wintertime, fall time, you know, and, you know, the seasons change, and what is the best way to get certain good fruits and vegetables? Because, you know, like, I was eating... It was this one restaurant that did, you know, they had a good salad, and they closed down. So they're trying to shut down, too, a lot of stuff.
You have to, you would have to plant your own food. Number one, you would get a trash bag, fill it up with dirt, rich, dark soil, and you can plant your seeds in there. And actually, you can have about 3 of them in the house. And so even during the wintertime, the sun shines through the window or whatever the case is. Either you can have full spectrum light bulbs in which that you can shine on them. And you can get the full spectrum light bulbs from out of Walmart or Lowe's or anywhere else in which that you can possibly get them from. But full spectrum lights is natural lights, just like the sunlight. So it's not like the lights the lights in which that the people have within the house. Well, I think it's called what's the name of it? Lindescent. I can't remember right now. But the light source that most people have in their home is not full spectrum. But you can get the full spectrum light bulbs, like I said, from Lowe's or either Home Depot or possibly even Walmart or somewhere like that. You know, see, the problem is that, you know, we're not manufacturing anything ourselves, so. Until we can get to that level, that's actually when we won't be able to get respect upon this planet. Right now, we have people taking care of us. And as long as we being provided for, we're going to be looked at as children and deemed as such, you know. I know you probably done heard today. I mean, it was a big thing going on TV, you know, about Obama being called a boy, you know, on the Al Sharpton show, as well as also being called a tall baby and, you know, and the guy who got fired from off of MSN who called him a dick. So, I mean, there's a lot of racial things going on right now, which that is
going
to come to a head.
And in my environment and everything too, brother. You know, but I'm standing strong, man, dealing with awareness and things like this, dealing with the brothers and sisters who are truly on this path. And I thank y'all very much.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, brother. All right. Peace and blessings.
Okay. Peace.
All right. Next caller. We're going to caller 404, Atlanta, Georgia. You're on the line.
This is Bruno Wally. Can you please touch on sun gazing? Something that I'm doing a little study on, and the results from sun gazing show that if you sun gaze a particular amount of time in the safe hours, can you explain that to some of the callers? Because I'm very much interested.
Yeah, well, okay. For stargazing, there's two times those that can be done is when the sun is coming up, between the hours of 6:30 to 8:30 in the mornings, and then as the sun goes down, between now during the summertime, between the hours of 7:30 to 8:30. All right.
Okay.
And then of course on the winter, then of course on the winter times between the hours of 4:30 to 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock. During the winter time. So I mean those are the times in which that you know you have to do it at. And stargazing simply means taking your shoes off, your feet. Standing on the ground barefooted so that you can absorb the prana or the chi or the ki from the ground itself. And as you breathe in, you will look at the sun, which is a star, during those time periods, and you will absorb the sunlight through your eyes as it resonates throughout your whole cellular structure. And you have 76 trillion cells. So, and those cells act as holograms, as we said earlier on tonight's show. So that means it is encapsulating that solar phatic energy, you know, and is going to the rest of the template, which is your body. So that is what is going on, and that is much needed because the sun itself, like we said, is the primary source of energy. So that is the science of stargazing. And the breath technique in which that you can use while you're stargazing is the breath technique in which that we've been talking about here lately is 6363. You breathe in for a count of six, hold it for six. Hold it for three, breathe out for a count of six, and hold it for three. So that's what you would do as you're doing it. And so you're absorbing stellar energy from the star, which is the sun, air, prana, as well as also ground prana. So you're absorbing all three prana simultaneously as you do that breath technique.
Thank you, brother.
Okay.
Please do.
All right, now. Peace, brother. Thank you. All right, we're going to go to caller. Swiftly, you're on the line.
You hear me, brother?
Yes, we hear, brother. Peace.
Peace. Have you tried any, like, that colloidal gold or monatomic gold, or is there anything that you've tried for the opening?
Yes, I have.
Does that work?
Yes, it does. Dr. Deborah Blair is a big pusher of that, and you can go to his website, www.metacenter.com or .org. You can go there, Dr. Deborah Blair. That's B-E-R-T, Deborah Blair, B-L-A-I-R, Deborah Blair, Dr. Deborah Blair. And you go to his website, and he sells the monatomic gold. Also, as well as also, you can go and check out Brother Joel Benjamin. We've had him here on the show several times, speaking on the metaphysics of water, alkaline water, and you can reach him. And you can reach him and go watch his videos on YouTube, and he'll tell you his information. But his name is Joel. That's J-O-E-L Benjamin, B-E-N-J-A-M-I-N. And he has several videos on YouTube that you can check out. We also sell those videos, so y'all can also hit us up at 252-257-3588, and we can get those videos out to y'all also from Dr. David Blair, but also from Brother Joe, Joel Benjamin.
Okay, thank you, brother.
All right, thank you, brother. Peace.
Peace. Peace.
All right, we got caller 338. Oh, excuse me, 336, Greensboro, North Carolina, North Kakarak, you on the line.
Yeah, what's going on, Dr. Lin-Bey? I just got two questions, man. All right. My girl, she's pregnant, and I'm trying to find out different ways for her to try to have the baby natural this time.
Right. Well, right now she's been taking red raspberry. And that needs to be the main herb that she's taking right now is red raspberry.
Okay, red raspberry.
Red raspberry. Okay. That will help with her ability in order to open her cervix area in order to get the push the child out naturally. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so right now she should be going, I think she's about 3.5 months. So should she take that now, start now? Okay. And, I have another question,
yeah,
man.
She can take that all the way up into the ninth month, yes.
Okay. Also, man, I just have a question about me. I tend to warm up a lot. I mean, I don't have high blood pressure, and I was listening to you about having the O-positive blood and everything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm O-positive, but I tend to, like heat up.
Is that from eating, or what is that from? Do you know? Because that's the how are you feeling? Is it like a tingling sensation, or just a heat sensation? I mean, what you experiencing?
I'm just experiencing like my whole body, mainly my chest area, around like with my shirts and stuff. I just warm up. It's like I just hold heat. Like for a long time, but it only happened like around like this time. Around this time of night, I always warm up.
All right. What time is it right now?
9:47 over here in North Carolina. All right.
So, between the hours of 9 and 11 is when it happens, right?
Yeah.
Okay. According to the reason why it's happening to your chest is because of the pericardium. According to Taoism, which when you check your 12 meridians, the meridian always that is controlled during this time period is your pericardium, which deals with the heart or chest area. So obviously that meridian is being cleansed out, and what I would do is actually meditate between the hours of 9 and 11 on that particular area, which is of your chest, in order to help with the cleansing process. Once again, going to take you some alkaline water. You can also increase the magnesium and the manganese and the zinc levels. Make sure you're taking in a lot of green leafy vegetables, because the color green is the color of the heart chakra. Make sure you have rose quartz crystals around, because rose is the secondary, which is pink, is the secondary color of the heart chakra.
All
right.
Okay.
And, so that's what you can do. Also, you can do a qigong move, which is qigong in which that actually you can raise your hands up as you inhale to the heart level. So you just breathe in, and as you breathe in, you raise your arms up. And then as you spread your arms out to the side, you would say, oh, the A-H sound. And the R sound helps with the lungs and the heart in order to cleanse and move that energy out the way. Any negative energy within those areas, it will help move it. Toxins and poisons, it will help move it. Mucus, it will help move it.
Okay,
so it helps. So once again, breathe in, raise your hands to the heart level, and then as you spread your hands out to the side, the A-H sound. And so those are the good things that you can do right now, all right?
Okay.
All right, brother.
All right, I appreciate it.
Oh, yeah, no problem. All right, let's go to the next caller. You got 704, Charlotte, North Carolina. Cackalack is in the house tonight. All right, Charlotte,
on the line. Techno 4.
Yeah.
Yes, peace, peace.
Peace, what's going on? This is Brother Justin from North Carolina.
All right.
And I'm just calling because a lot of people seem to be confused on the meal process. Like, you know, there's a lot of information out there talking about eat every 3 hours and stuff like that. I'm wondering if there was a science behind the eating and the timing
and
stuff.
It depends on if you have a disposition towards diabetes. If diabetes runs within the family, then eating more smaller food, more small meals throughout the day would be more beneficial to a person who does not have that within their family genetics or their bloodline or heritage. So it all depends.
Yeah,
it also depends too on the blood types. So this is why we were talking about going to get how to eat right for the 4 basic blood types too, by Dr. Peter Diamanto. So you know these are things that we have to investigate and get more information about, so that we can be up to par on our health and nutrition, because right now, you know, the majority of diabetes cases are us. The majority of kidney disease is us. The majority of heart disease is us. The majority of prostate cancer is us. So until we can get a fix on our dispositions, the foods that we need to eat based on our blood type, these breathing exercises, you know what I'm saying, and the science of how to absorb prana or chi or ki, raw energy, into the system and how to store it properly so that we can extend our life force and extend the telomeres on our DNA, you know, then this is when we can correct the genetic problems on which that we have dispositions towards. Until then, you know, we just out here being led to slaughter, you know what I'm saying? It's just part of the population control agenda of the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds and the rest of the so-called Illuminati, the Bilderbergs, Trilateral Commission, Council on Foreign Relations, IMF, whatever you want to refer to them as. They all sit on the same council and commissions, and they all intermarry into each other, and they all make plans on how to dominate and make obedient to people who are here upon the planet Earth.
Okay,
you know,
yeah,
so we have,
yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much answering my question. I just see a lot of, you know, I used to work at a gym, and I saw a lot of people just really confused about that and trying to figure out. And I always thought
right.
It was like, you know, based on digestion time. And,
you know. Hold up. You just said it, too. If you work at a gym and you're trying to gain muscle weight, then you would eat more. That's just normal. That's natural. You know, say if you're trying to lose weight, then guess what? You would eat less. But in losing weight, you have to add iodine into the meal. In other words, you have to make sure you get the proper sea salt or sea vegetables or herbs in order to take so that you can lose the weight naturally. In other words, you don't have to go to liposuction.
Exactly.
In other words, you don't have, you know, in other words, you don't have to, you know, run yourself raggedy and starve yourself, get bulimia and anorexia. You know, in order to do this. Only thing you have to do is just up your metabolism, which is based on the function of your thyroid gland. That's
so,
what,
I mean, so...
And the only thing your thyroid gland needs is salt. It needs iodine.
Iodine. So what would be the good ratio of adding iodine, like sea salt, to canned in water?
You can take actually like a pinch or so and just stir it into the water and just drink it. Every morning or every time in which that you drink about 16 ounces of water, you take about a pinch or so and put it in the water and just stir it on up and drink it.
Okay. Well, I appreciate that, family.
All right.
All right, peace.
All right, peace. All right. All right, we got some technical difficulties once more. And so we're going to go back into... We can get everything back up to par. You know, going back to some information. And it's about time for us to head on over here. Anyway, so we're going to do some suggestions. We spoke about the Irish sea moss. Not only do you can take the iris from sea moss, or you can take kelp, or you can take kombu, nori, bladder wrack, dus. These are all sea vegetables, all right? With this, you wouldn't need sea salt, iodine, you know, because all of these sea vegetables have it naturally, all right? So you can actually take that instead. Dulce is spelled D-U-L-S-E. You have kombu, C-O-M-B-U, wakame, that's W-A-K-A-M-E. You have hijiki, which is H-I-J-I-K-I. You have arani, which is A-R-A-N-E. And nori, N-O-R-I. All right, so these are just some of the sea vegetables in which that we can use on a daily basis in order to help with the weight loss. Kelp is known to be excellent for weight loss. And the chlorophyll is a greasy pigment. The only difference between chlorophyll and your melanin is one magnesium molecule. That's it. Otherwise, you'd be green. And doctors and scientists will tell you that your magnesium molecule is dormant, just like your vitamin C is dormant. So that means that you have to take it in from secondary sources. Hence, I eat plants, vegetables, fruits, sun. All right? And, of course, if you look at the back of the baby near the buttocks area, right above the crack of the behind, which is where the kundalini energy resonates at, oftentimes you will see a greenish tint of the baby after it comes out the womb, in which that some refer to as the birthmark. But normally that birthmark over time disappears. Well, that was once the green tint of our whole physical body, because at one time we had more gold and copper in our bodies. Dr. Deborah Blair speaks about this. Dr. Malachi York speaks about this in the Melanite Children, as well as also Dr. Phil Valentine speaks about this. So these are all things in which that when you get into it is verified through research and through scholarship. So chlorophyll, the green pigment, is important in plants. In fact, it can be recognized as the green blood of plants, all right, supplying nutrients to the plant cells. It's the chlorophyll molecules in plants that traps the energy from the sun. And when we eat the green plants, this solar energy becomes our energy. All right, once again, this is a secondary source. So herbs of alkaline and alkaline foods are fundamental to good health and for the body's natural healing. Pain and disease in the body is caused by a buildup of toxins around the cells, which creates an acidic or acid state as opposed to an alkaline state. A variety of alkaline herbs can assist in the body to clear acid waste. So when our bodies is very acidic, we are unable to readily absorb minerals and other nutrients from the foods that we eat. Then the blood is slow to repair damaged cells and detoxify heavy metals and other toxins. This reduced functions weakens the immune system, which is a defense system, and we are more susceptible to fatigue and illness, and tumor cells can then thrive. So our cells love alkaline. So our cells love alkaline water, alkaline herbs, alkaline food, and this is what we must do every day is alkaline ourselves. Peace and blessings, Hotep. Assalamu alaikum. Shalom. Islam. Peace.
First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays.
others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories and shit that works.